Hey everybody, how's it going? It's the Daily Shooter, and today we're going to be taking a look at a holster that kind of does it all. This is the Saya from LAS Concealment. Let's go ahead and take a closer look. Now, when I was originally on the market for a holster, I wanted something that really checked a lot of boxes, and that's because I had a lot of needs in this holster due to the fact that it was going to be for my Glock 17 that has some modifications to it. I wanted something that was light-bearing, that would support the Surefire XH35, suppressor height sights, and a Trigicon RMR. I also wanted something that was inside the waistband and still had a sweat guard. That's kind of asking a lot. A lot of times when you go to a holster website, you'll see that they have maybe three different drop-down menus. One will say right or left-handed, one will say, do you want a cant? And then the other one will say, is it light-bearing and do you want to put a light on it? And sometimes they'll have a good selection, sometimes they'll only have a few lights that you can use it with. And again, I wanted kind of everything. I wanted the perfect holster for my Glock 17 that would fit all of these different things. And when you go over to LAS Concealment, you'll see that they have a drop-down menu that really does ask exactly what you're looking for and exactly what you want. It makes it really highly customizable. So that's what I got. I have an inside the waistband holster that you can wear at either 4 o'clock, that you can wear appendix. It is set up for suppressor height sights. It's also set up to accept the Trigicon RMR. It also has a nice sweat guard to it. I mean, this thing really does kind of cover everything, and it fits absolutely perfect and is custom designed for the Surefire XH35. So again, it's a holster that had to check a lot of boxes because I had a lot of needs, and I am really impressed. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you, just even a couple years ago, if you would have asked me about, you know, specific holsters and Kydex and things like that that were out there, I would have told you Kydex is Kydex. But holsters like this have come so far. I mean, just in the way that they're designed, their overall technology that is put into actually making these is a lot different. Back in the days, guys used to just press Kydex on a gun, and so the retention that you would get would always be different. It wouldn't be really consistent. They would just press the Kydex, move on, press the Kydex, cut it, move on. These are really, really nice formed Kydex shells. And they offer you a lot more in the versatility that you get out of one of these than they would even just a year or two ago. Now, I have two different holsters from them, and I will show them both to you. This one right here has the double clips, and they don't use these really kind of cheap, flimsy clips. They use a really nice, thick, heavy-duty clip, and it also has an angled latch at the bottom. So when this thing goes onto your belt, goes inside your waistband, locks onto your belt, it locks on really tight. It's not going anywhere, and it retains its shape. That's one of the nice things that I like about inside the waistband and Kydex is that you can reholster, you can draw, you always get the same draw and the same reholster every single time. And it does hold on really nice, and it also has this little attachment on the side right here, which helps reduce printing. Because a lot of times when you have an inside the waistband holster, especially one that's kind of minimalist like this, maybe that's more designed for appendix carry, but also can be worn at the 4 o'clock position, is when it's slender like this, it kind of gives you a bulge out of the side, and then it's easy to see the gun when it's, you know, underneath your shirt. But by extending it out a little bit further with this little piece that's on the side right here, it kind of also extends the profile of the holster, meaning that it's going to conceal a lot better. So I like that they added that. Now, this one right here has the double clips. This one right here is pretty much the same holster, a little bit of a design difference, but pretty much the same holster, but this one is set up to accept a Safariland clips. So these Safariland clips will fit perfect in this design right here, where this design is set up to either sit perfectly straight up and down or goes all the way to a 15 degree cant. So it does offer some versatility in the type of clips that we can use and in the direction in which you use them. Now, I know I say this every single time I review a holster, but these are the three most important things that I consider when I'm shopping for a holster, and I think they're the three most important things about a holster, period. One is, how well does it protect the trigger? I want a holster that completely protects the trigger. That means that no foreign debris or anything like that can get inside that trigger guard and activate that trigger. Because if I am carrying, like they say here, loaded and safe, I want to make sure that the gun is safe. And the only way that this gun is going to be going off is if something gets in that trigger guard and actually physically pulls on that trigger. So I want to make sure that I have a nice safe holster, and this definitely covers that. Another thing that I'm looking for is retention. How well does it hold on to the gun? I mean, that's what a holster really is for. Protecting that trigger guard, holding on to the gun. So I want a good positive click, even if I have a light. You know, there's some holsters out there where I've gotten them, they are light bearing, and they don't have a nice positive retention because somehow the light maybe caused some added pressure to the holster or whatever, and it just didn't click right. I want something with a good positive retention. This has that. It holds onto the gun, no problem at all. This is a full-size gun. It does have a loaded magazine, nothing in the chamber, but I wanted to make it kind of as heavy as I could get it to show you guys that it's in there good. This also offers adjustable retention, so that's one of the more important things as well. Being able to adjust it, if it does get a little bit loose, you can tighten it up a bit. Now, the next most important thing to me when I'm buying a holster is looking at how well is it gonna stay on my belt. What type of clips do they use? Do they use clips? Do they use belt loops? Are they thick? Are they thin? Do they look like the type that are gonna wear out? Are they gonna bend? I mean, how well is it gonna actually stay on my belt? Because the last thing I'm gonna wanna do is draw my gun from the holster and have the holster come out with the gun like this, and now I can't get to the actual trigger, and I'm gonna have to pull it off. I want to get a nice clean draw from the holster and be able to present my firearm when I need it, and I want the holster to stay either on the inside or on the outside of my pants. So taking a look at the clips is extremely important to me, and I like the fact that you have options here. These are really nice thick clips. They do allow for a little bit of adjustability in the cant and so forth, but they're very nice. They're thick clips. They have a nice hook on them. And again, you also have the options of going between these types of clips, and I believe they also have a single clip as well, and then again, the Safariland stuff. So I like the fact that there is some adjustability in the clip section, again, because that's, to me, one of my top three things. So how well does it hold the gun? How well does it protect the trigger? And how well does it stay on your belt? Now, I've been wearing this holster for quite a while now. As a matter of fact, I was able to wear it to Vegas just recently and kind of trek around with a full-size pistol on me. And I gotta say, it is an extremely comfortable holster. If you guys watch the channel regularly, you've probably seen it several times up here on the safe. And that's because when I'm working on a review for something, especially like this, I want to use it as much as possible before I give you guys my final report. And I really like this holster. I love the overall design. I like that it's kind of a minimalist feel to it, so it doesn't have a very big print, which is great, especially when you're carrying a full-size firearm like this. You don't want too much going on. So I like the fact that this is kind of minimalist. I like the way that it protects the trigger guard. It meets all of my criteria for retention in the belt clips. But again, it also had a lot of the things that I just wanted. For instance, I wanted the sweat guard, but I didn't want it to impede the Trigicon RMR. I wanted something for a flashlight. They offer so many different flashlights in their drop-down menu that if you guys have a flashlight for your weapon, including an Olight PL2 Valkyrie, just choose the one for the Streamlight TLR1 HL, and that will work with your Olight flashlight, okay? So just keep that in mind. It's not a perfect fit, and it does sit a little bit offset, but they do sit in the holster nice and still offer you protection and retention. So just keep that in mind if you're looking for something for your Olight. Nonetheless, it's a great holster. It's definitely worth checking out. They make some of the nicer holsters on the market. I'll put links down below where you can check them out. Definitely check out their Instagram as well, because they're always coming out with some new stuff, different things to look at. And again, these are custom-made holsters to exactly your needs. So there's a little bit of a lead time sometimes. So if you want to buy one, I suggest you get on it soon, because of those lead times, and lead times going up even probably after this video, you want to get in on it kind of quick. You know, it's one of those things where, depending on how much you want done to this holster, it could take a little bit longer. Anyway, thank you all very much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Please like, subscribe, and you guys have a great day.